Okay, if I only get like a bus shot, I can get the street rather than get all your feet. Would you rather?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, we want to get the street lights too, right?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I got you from a
Can we do yours?
That's great.
Can we do yours?
Well, that's a nice shot. I didn't know the teacher.
Citadel Wall here in Quebec City. It's kind of dark and hazy right now, but it's not cold at all.
That street there, let's say, starts the main part of, let's say, of restaurants and disco bars and bars in that corner.
Check, huh? Mm-hmm. That would be an experience.
But I trust you people to stop them on the way.
Oh, we'll stop. This is the lobby. Famous hotel du Fountainec. Want to know? This is the rear terrace of the Fountainec Hotel, and it's raining. Flowers that the bride sent in their bouquets at the altar. This is the end of Beaupré again. We made a second trip because we missed a lot. It's so big, so many things to see. ascend on their knees in a spirit of penitent love these holy stairs, recalling those of Pilate's Praetorium. The Stations of the Cross at St. Anne de Beaupré, the Crucifixion. Beautiful, and I tell you, the weather is so pretty today among these lovely autumn trees. It's really a beautiful sight. And you can see the St. Lawrence in the distance. Relic of St. Anne de Beaupré, a portion of the bone in her forearm encased in that glass enclosure on the altar.
Tell them where you're going.
We're going to the La Chute St. Anne. That's waterfalls.
And the Grand Canyon.
And the Grand Canyon. Hello. Right out of St. Anne de Beaupré, Quebec. And it's 11:45. And what do you think the temperature's on?
In the high 30s.
You think? Oh, I think it's 40 degrees. I like 40 degrees. Oh, God. Some of the water splashing in our face. It's coming down so hard. This is called the Grand Canyon of St. Anne. And we've never seen anything like this. And it's not even in our AAA book. It's a site we found by talking to everybody around here. They all talk about it. But it's not published very much on the AAA tour books.
Something.
Good.
Huh?
You receiving?
Yeah, it says they're recording
us.
Ed Chung from Fremont.
And Eddie. Come out here and talk to me. Oh, yes. And what is your name?
Betty.
Hi. Betty. California. California.
Yeah.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
You can catch the rainbow almost. Look. See along the edge right here? Look. See the rainbow?
Alright, go ahead.
talent. I think it says 1974. That little bridge crosses right over the falls, actually, the Grand Canyon area. All is from the St. Anne River.
Was a sign of the turnoff for the inn that was staying at Baker's. Right out of St. Anne de Beaupré. beautiful area in here. Lots of forms. It's the St. Lawrence River behind these little houses.
Got it?
Not too much distance from where.
All the way back up? There's nothing.
Yeah.
Le soleil qui semble vouloir effectuer une timide du FM 103. On fera le tirage de paires de billets. La tournée 14-18, une présentation des productions TPG et de votre FM progressif.
CFCO.
St. Lawrence River, and it is pretty, I'm telling you. Supposed to be reminiscent of what France looked like many hundred years ago. Mountain, those are ski slopes. I am. need to go on. I'm trying to get the mountains across the road. The apple trees. See the apple trees?
It's just got one. It's good.
This is the Minois Montmorency. It's a hotel, restaurant, overlooking the Montmorency Falls. Right outside of Quebec. On the way to Saint-Anne-de-Beaupré. Balcony of the Montmorency Hotel, looking right at the Montmorency Falls. This is the bridge that goes to the Ildel Inns that we just rode around this evening over the St. Lawrence River, of course. Believe it or not, they're coming down Highway 360. And we're right in the middle of the road.
o'clock and you can see the snowflakes. I'm getting ready to leave Quebec. And this is the inn where we stayed two nights. It was beautiful.
Oh, how simply stunning those legs are.
Several times.
Now that's the real thing. We're leaving on Highway 138 at the moment. We're going toward Quebec City and we'll be leaving for Riviera du Loup. We were so lucky to have a beautiful day yesterday. This is a waterfall again in Riviera du Loup. There are supposed to be 8 such falls around here. This, however, is the highest. Wish we could see all 8 of them, but I think you'll be spared from that because we don't have time to see all 8. It is cold today. Look at the lovely park here over on the side. To your right. This is looking straight ahead, leaving Riviera du Loup on Highway 185 South. And it's starting to snow a lot. We might be snowed in tonight. Center in New Brunswick. We've never seen anything quite like it.
It's you.
If this looks blurry, it's nothing wrong with the camera. I think we're in a blizzard. We're leaving the tourist information center in New Brunswick. That's all snow out there. And Billy, your camera got full of snow, but I wiped it off right away.
Put it on.
Almost the end of the day. That started out with that snowstorm this morning. Snowstorm to us, that is.
Thank you. did not go down, and so it went in the only other available direction, which was up. So now we know. Where would we all be without these experts who explain things to us? The algae farm. Those are people who once again, making things clean and bright. Helping to
farm services. 20 kilogram bags of field and farmer reduced to 6 now by 25%. For more details on checkerboard fall values at J&P Farm Services, see the flyer in today's newspaper. J&P Farm Services, they are present in Sussex, on our number 4 Amherst, and 30 Checker Drive in Moncton. Back to good points or less, guaranteed the longest.
We're now going backwards uphill at Magnetic Hill in neutral. The car is it on? The car's on.
Yes, the engine's running.
The engine's on, but we're in neutral and we're going backwards. That's really strange. On Magnetic Hill, right outside of Moncton in New Brunswick. Go do it. Going down now toward the Magnetic Hill Phenomena spot.
So he tried coming up forward and it wouldn't do it.
It feels like you're going uphill and yet you're going downhill. Let's see if I can get this on in here. Go slow.
Okay. Keep going because I'm going to come right over here like I'm supposed to. And I'm going to put my car in neutral. Okay, it's going in neutral. And there I'm going up.
Car's in neutral and we're going backwards uphill. That's the phenomenon of Magnetic Hill, Magic Hill, I think they call it. This is the rocks at the Provincial Park in New Brunswick, just a few miles south of Moncton. This is where the tides go out and come in and cover the rocks that look like flower pots. Every day, it completely covers these. The tide will be coming in soon. About 2 hours from now, all this area will be completely covered when the tides come up. The tides are what have cut these caves out of this rock, sandstone-like area. We can only be on the beach about 20 more minutes because the tides come in so fast you almost can't get away from them, they tell us. It's the Bay of Fundy that comes rushing in here, part of the Petit Cordillac. In a little while, right where I'm standing, it'll all be wet. They tell us the tides come up more than 30 feet. Every day they go out and come and rise almost 30 feet right in this area.
there this morning.
Yeah. You can see the tide coming in now, though.
This is the Rock Provincial Park, where the tide will rise soon and flood all of this area we're looking at right now. It's at Hopewell Cape, New Brunswick.
Okay.
The rocks here at the Provincial Park are at the mouth of the Petty Kodiak River, and that's what floods all this area. The water's continually to come up as we're watching it. It happens every day at high tide.
This rock that I am focusing on will be underwater in another hour or so. And look at the height of it.
Try and catch me, huh?
this is 4 o'clock, about 3.5 hours since we took the first pictures. Which means it's about a 36 foot tidal surge since the low tide, when almost all of this area where you see the rocks was all beach. When we first came, it was all beach, well past the rocks. They tell us this is the highest tidal change of any area in the world. I don't know if that's true, but it certainly is something to see. Mm-hmm. It was all beach way over those rocks in our first pictures that we took this evening. It's about 4:10. And this beach has just been completely covered in the last 3 or 4 hours.
This is where they had almost 200 foot of beach. And now you have 20 feet of it.
This is a Fundy National Park in New Brunswick. We're crossing the border, coming back to the USA, at Calais, New Brunswick. We had rain all day, cloudy, cold.
By Movieland coming up. If you haven't been to Movieland lately, you don't know what.
Thank you. I'll catch you tomorrow. I'll catch you tomorrow. I'll see you in front.
This is in the Canadian, the Acadian National Park in Bar Harbor, Maine. There's not much sun today, but it's still pretty.
Where are you?
Daddy says the water's crystal clear. Beautiful.
Ice.
Icy.
Big eagle feather here.
Daddy says it's an eagle feather, right there. This is a leaf peeping weekend up here in Maine. That's what they call it. And this is a color weekend. The peak of there are a number of carriage paths here in the Acadian Park where cars may not go, but you can take a ride in a carriage that looks just like that. There are a lot of bicycle paths too. That's all right, go ahead. It's a video. You'll look nice passing through. We'll take the picture off. Where are y'all from?
From London.
London? My, a long way.
You think they look like bubbles?
No, I think they mean this pond just bubbled up.
Oh, is that it? From the glaciers like they had in the movie?
Look at the sun.
Yeah. Doesn't stay out long though.
They have something to tell them. You have it on?
Yeah.
Our leaf peeping is getting a whole lot better because the sun came out. The trees and the shrubbery and colors are less affected here than in Gatlinburg because there isn't as much pollution and not nearly the number of people.
Gorham Mountain.
Gorham, okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
This is Gorham Mountain in Acadian Park, Bar Harbor, Maine, and the sun's out beautiful and it feels. This is a sand beach in Acadian Park, and that's the Atlantic Ocean out there. I sure like to come here in the summer, it must be nice. But it's pretty and warm today and sunny. This is a different kind of beach than we ever see. The sand's not nearly as white as in Florida, and it seems coarse, like not so fine and white, but it's lovely. Really lovely. Put a people in. I'm gonna take off my jacket. Daddy just got a lifetime pass to visit any national park in the United States. Free, golden ages. We were so surprised. Just as we entered this park, they gave Daddy the pass. The Atlantic Ocean.
When he got one of these, he gave up all his moving picture equipment and other kind.
And he got one of these instead?
Yeah, he got one of those instead.
Are you from Maine?
Well, no, I'm from the islands, Manhattan, Staten, and
Long. Oh, I'm headed that way. And I was worried about driving through New York. I have never driven.
Yeah.
Have to get down the same way you got up. You don't see no nests there?
What?
Yeah, he doesn't have a nest built there, or she? No, huh?
Large places that are surrounding, and then some your inner tidal zone is an area simply where the high tide covers up the low tide uncovers. There are creatures that only exist in that inner tidal zone.
100 feet beneath that buoy, attached by a piece of line to the buoy, and the different colors on the buoys are merely a personal identification code for the individual lobstermen. There are about 10,000 lobstermen in the state of Maine this year. Some of those guys fish up to 1,500 traps, so you can readily appreciate the necessity for a personal identification code. 100 of them on that island. There's another guillemot ahead of us at 12 o'clock. He just went down. On her way home, she sailed on the SS Titanic and went down on the Titanic, and the professor was so hard put and behind the high seas house here. We call it the Titanic house, really. Probably some of the most expensive property here on Mount Desert Island, primarily because it is bordered on the front by Acadia National Park.
High, the females anyway, are 42 inches high and weigh as much as 15 pounds. The males range around 36 inches high and weigh approximately 12, 13 pounds. You can't sex them because they both take on the same coloring. It's the same white on the head and tail feather, so unless you make an extremely close observation, which I wouldn't recommend if the eagle is alive, the eagle won't let go. Not that many of you will ever encounter an eagle in one way or the other, but if you do, it's good to know. As some people have, in fact, gone up thinking, oh, poor bird, pick them up. Next thing you know, they're in total agony. Now, the eagles live to be around 25 years in the wild. There you go, lady, big, come on here, give it to Premature bald eagle, just off the port side.
It's a bald eagle. This whole cruise was in Frenchman's Bay in Boa Harbor.
Yeah, quite possible. Goes
right into the Atlantic Ocean.
You know, now this is, that might be why the other eagle's leaving. See, he's going right after him. Yeah. He's chasing the other one off, yeah. There's the eagle over here at 10 o'clock. So we got two immatures and a mature. When we see this kind of combination, by the way, it's another down until we're just about to hit water and then they'll break. But there's definitely some confrontation happening here. Quite possible this may be one of the young of this particular eagle, as this pair on this island have produced, here we go. Oh yeah, great. This is gonna be interesting. Ever seen, with the exception of a couple times in the last 6 years, any kind of combat on the part of the eagles. Here comes some more over here, I think. Okay. We'll stay here and watch this, Michelle. Here's two more coming this way. This other eagle is chasing the other immature. So we got double combat going. This is going to be wild. Now watch the move. See the talons on the other one just come out? He's chasing that immature. They will drive off their own young, no matter when they return. Yeah, look at that. Great, huh?
South. on 95 South. We're on Highway 95 South, Main Turnpike. The color around it's really pretty. To Kennebunkport to see what the president sees when he comes on vacation. Pretty little town. We're going toward the Atlantic Ocean and the beach where he goes fishing. There are a lot of American flags displayed all along the route to Kennebunkport.
And country, hour number one. Of course, she'll be here till about.
And I guess he sees this traffic all the time too.
Stop country favorites, all those goodies from yesterday, and today, even some from tomorrow. Coming up at 1 o'clock today, we've got a parade in town.
Summer home. He's in Camp David today, so I think we can get probably closer and better pictures. Does he have a beautiful spot? Right across the street from Walker's Point. And this is what the president sees, looking right out of his windows, right across the way, at Walker's Point. Shoreline of Maine with all its rocks, the Atlantic Ocean, street on the little road we're parked. It looks right at the president's. This is the area right behind the president's place where they probably have a restricted area. This is the rear area behind Bush's summer home where they're probably Secret Service men and Coast Guard boats out there in the Atlantic. about the closest shot I can get from the back. See the traffic and the sightseers. The little shopping areas down in County Bunkport, right near the president's place. A lot of tourists today, even though the president's not here. There are some vacancies in the motel, though. We saw some signs. Lots of motels seem to have vacancies. Lots of people are downtown. During Boston, Massachusetts. And there's a lot of traffic on the bridge. Underpasses, bridges, everything looks dirty.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And we're going to go over the Benjamin Franklin Bridge. Historical District of Philadelphia. We're going to make a turn right in to see the Liberty Bell. And we're going to see the Liberty Bell and Independence Hall. Tell them where it is?
No, go ahead. Go ahead, say it again.
1774.
Say it again.
The First Continental Congress in this building, 1774. One of the flags used in the Continental Army. This is the portrait of the Marquis de Lafayette. He was instrumental in purchasing Louisiana, I believe. But they don't say so on his picture. I think that's who he is. Hanging here in the Customs House. In Philadelphia. George Washington. Penn was the founder of the city of Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, from which we get the name Pennsylvania, of course, too. This is Independence Hall in Philadelphia. And over to the right is Old City Hall. The little building right there that joins. Old City Hall. And on the left is where Congress met. Congress Hall with $20 a carriage.
Yeah.
off the buses come. And in the distance is the glass enclosed living house.
She pulls it in enormous amount. And so the creator realized there's none of them.
Signing the declaration took place. It's pretty flowers down here. Not all of the men who signed the Declaration signed the Constitution, but seven of them signed votes, like George Washington, Madison, Adams. There are only candles up there to light this room, as of course there was no electricity then, and that's the original chair that George Washington sat in. Center. There were banquets served in here and dancing. This is a governor's quarters in a state building, now known as Independence Hall. Very good. Assembly Chambers is the official name of this room.
Thank you.
downtown Baltimore, Maryland, and we're going to the Inner Harbor. This is the Bounty in the Inner Harbor in downtown Baltimore, Maryland. Show them some of the convention center. Constellation in the harbor here in Baltimore, Maryland. It's really pretty. It shows you what you could do with the Mississippi River at home. Convention centers all around the river, places to get something to eat, shopping.
All right, stay right there. I'll be there.
What is your name?
Pardon?
What is your name?
I'm Will Priest. I'm a gunner's mate.
Gunner's mate?
The uniform is 1861.
1861?
Wow.
Doesn't look that old.
Well, sometimes I feel it, ma'am. Arthritis kicks in, I feel it. We have all sorts of displays around here.
Do you sail now?
I know, ma'am. I work aboard the Constellation.
Does it move it from here to
no.
The handrail will go down.
That's
where I'm going.
All right.
This ship was launched in 1797 here in Baltimore. The oldest ship still afloat. It never leaves Baltimore Harbor anymore. Oh, you can see the hammocks where they sleep there.
Oh, yeah. This is the second deck. Down. We have one more deck to go. We're going to go down to the bottom deck. Clothes? Yeah, took a picture of it.
This is actually the guy.
Are these the original cannons on here?
No, they're fiberglass representations. There are two.
And this is the galley where they prepared food for 400 men aboard. Seems impossible. Look at the oven over here. That's the only thing they had for a stove.
And how about the lake stand?
400 men had to eat from here.
And the
Federalist plan. For the enemy, we're for the British. For the British ship. For the enemy, yes.
You might want something from what I see, the damn galley down the aisle.
Well, there you are.
Oh.
Unusual statues. They're not Hummels, but they're almost as expensive. Heading out on 95 South.